demonstrating a level of flexibility that no other commercial launch provider on Earth can likely match. SpaceX and OneWeb have entered into a major launch contract, barely 3 weeks after Russia kicked the satellite internet company off of its Soyuz rockets. Roscosmos set some strict conditions for foreign companies, with previously signed contracts to launch aboard the Soyuz rocket from Russian soil. Roscosmos refused to launch OneWeb's broadband satellites, after the British company did not agree with Russia's demands. The conditions Russia imposed are, that OneWeb internet service cannot be used for military purposes, and that the British government divests its shareholder stake in the company. Roscosmos threatened to cancel all contracts with OneWeb if the conditions were not accepted. The United Kingdom refused its conditions and OneWeb ended all ties with Russia, then selected US company SpaceX to launch its broadband satellites. After this, Russia erased painted over the American, Britain, and Japan flags out of the Soyuz rocket's exterior. Beginning in early 2020, OneWeb has launched approximately 430 operational small internet satellites, about two-thirds of its first constellation. On a dozen different Russian Soyuz 2.1B and Saint V rockets, including a mission completed as recently as February 10, 2022. That nominal, albeit slow, deployment ground to a violent halt alongside Russia's second unprovoked invasion of Ukraine, on February 24, 2022. Within a week, extraordinary Western economic sanctions pushed the unstable head of Russia's Roscosmos space agency to retaliate by both ending the practice of European-owned Soyuz launches and holding OneWeb's 13th operational launch hostage. Another 3 weeks later, outside of increasingly tense and reluctant cooperation on the International Space Station, the relationship between Russian and Western spaceflight programs has effectively ceased to exist. That includes all 6 to 7 of OneWeb's remaining Soyuz launch contracts, each of which the company had already paid more than $50 million for. Though OneWeb technicians were able to escape the increasingly hostile country, Russia effectively repossessed OneWeb's remaining rockets and its 13th batch of operational satellites. That left OneWeb in an unsurprisingly precarious situation. Having already gone bankrupt once, a major delay could be financially catastrophic for the company. Normally, procuring half a dozen near-term launch contracts at the last second would be virtually impossible. Indeed, ignoring a certain US company, no other launch provider on Earth could even theoretically find, or build enough capacity to launch the last third of OneWeb's constellation, without at least a 1 or 2 year delay. Luckily for OneWeb, SpaceX does exist. OneWeb is a competitor to SpaceX's Starlink broadband constellation. It aims to build a constellation of 648 satellites in low Earth orbit, to provide internet coverage to customers globally, similar to Starlink, which consists of 12,000 satellites to also provide internet across the world. As of today, SpaceX operates around 2,200 satellites in orbit launched by Falcon 9 since 2019. And OneWeb operates 428 of its satellites, that were all launched on Russia's Soyuz rocket. OneWeb's satellites will now launch atop SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket. We thank SpaceX for their support, which reflects our shared vision for the boundless potential of space, said OneWeb CEO Neil Masterson. With these launch plans in place, we're on track to finish building out our full fleet of satellites and deliver robust, fast, secure connectivity around the globe. Demand for OneWeb's broadband connectivity services has continued to grow across telecommunications providers, aviation and maritime markets, and governments worldwide. OneWeb has activated service with its network at the 50th parallel and above, and early partners are initiating service, they stated in a press release on March 21. SpaceX, a direct competitor that is far more vertically integrated than OneWeb, and has suffered no major issues from Russian sanctions, may be OneWeb's only near-term option for its orphaned satellites. The only obvious alternative would be to self-inflict what could be years of delays to avoid SpaceX purely out of spite, and instead wait for space to open up on the manifests of companies like Arianespace and ULA, or for even less available rockets from India or Japan. SpaceX has plans for as many as 52-plus Falcon launches in 2022, many of which are Starlink missions, that the company might be willing to partially replace with a handful of lucrative launches for OneWeb. Because of SpaceX's exceptional vertical integration, and decision to launch its own Starlink internet satellites, which directly compete with OneWeb. The company has dozens of flexible launches planned over the next year or two, that it can feasibly convert into commercial missions. No other international launch provider on Earth has the ability to scavenge its own internal manifest, to effectively create capacity for last-second commercial demand out of thin air. At the cost of a handful of Starlink launches, of which SpaceX already has close to 2,100 working satellites in orbit, the company will be able to almost heroically step in and complete OneWeb's constellation, allowing the company to avoid a potential multi-year delay if forced to use other providers. In fact, due to Europe's chronic lack of domestic launch capacity, as a result of years of Ariane 6 delays, even some institutional European satellites orphaned by Russia's actions may ultimately be moved to SpaceX Falcon 9 rockets to avoid lengthy launch delays. All told, OneWeb has offered no specific details about the cost, the number of total missions procured, or any other changes implemented in its new SpaceX contract. But the company says it could begin launches as early as this summer, a truly extraordinary demonstration of flexibility from both OneWeb and SpaceX. NASA, which jointly manages the International Space Station with Roscosmos, has said it intends to continue cooperating with its Russian counterparts. The two partners had been negotiating an agreement to launch Russian astronauts on Crew Dragon, a SpaceX vehicle that carries NASA astronauts. Beyond cooperation with NASA, Russia said on Thursday it would halt the sale of rocket engines to American companies. In a situation like this, we can't supply the United States with our world's best rocket engines, Mr. Rogozin said on Russian state television. Let them fly on something else, their broomsticks, I don't know what. The freeze may most acutely affect Northrop Grumman, which uses Russian-made engines for its Antares launch vehicle, that ferries cargo to the space station for NASA. SpaceX also provides this service to the space station, as do spacecraft launched by Japan and Russia. In a more symbolic move, Mr. Rogozin said, Russia would no longer provide assistance in the use of a different Russian engine already purchased, and in use by United Launch Alliance for Atlas V, one of the most frequently used American rockets. Europe's space agency has cancelled several launches on Russian rockets, a contract between privately held OneWeb and Roscosmos for six Soyuz launches has been nullified. Europe suspended work on its ExoMars exploration mission, that was set to use a Russian rocket and lander, and Russia has vowed to stop selling rocket engines to US launch companies. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.